Hello. Today I'm going to discuss on the topic nuclear reactions and how you can arrive at the balanced reaction. Let us start by reviewing on the basic concepts of atoms. I believe these were already discussed during your chemistry or physics courses. According to Dalton's atomic theory, an atom is defined as the basic unit of an element that can take part in the chemical combination. But succeeding studies demonstrated that atoms are made up of even smaller particles referred to as subatomic particles. However, the subatomic particles that are important to chemistry are the elementary particles that includes the electrons, protons, and neutrons. The protons and the neutrons of an atom are packed in extremely small nucleus at the center, while the electrons are shown as clouds moving around the nucleus. Recall that writing the symbols for various chemical elements explicitly indicate protons, neutrons, and electrons. Thus, for an element X, it must show the number of protons, in this case, the subscript notation Z. In a neutral atom, the number of protons, which we also refer to as the atomic number, is numerically equal to the number of electrons. Hence, for carbon, the number of protons or atomic number is 6. So the number of electrons is 6. On the other hand, the atomic mass is denoted by the superscript notation A, which is equal to 12 for carbon. The atomic mass is equal to the total number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. Thus, the number of neutrons is calculated by subtracting the total number of protons from the atomic mass. In the case of carbon, the number of neutrons is equal to 12 minus 6 or equal to 6. In accordance with the notation I discussed a while ago, the atomic number Z of a proton in the matrix shown is 1. Since there is one proton present and the atomic mass A is 1, the neutrons present is therefore 0, because the neutron is equal to the atomic mass minus the number of protons. This is the same with hydrogen. On the other hand, the atomic mass A of a neutron N is 1, but its atomic number Z, or the number of protons, is 0. For the electron, the atomic mass is 0, therefore, there are no protons and neutrons. However, with the atomic number equal to negative 1, the atomic number being referred to is that of the electron, since it is the electron that has a unit negative charge. The symbol E with superscript 0 and negative 1 as the subscript represents an electron in or from an atomic orbital. The cloud represented by the ring moving in the atomic structure is the atomic orbital. The symbol beta with superscript 0 and subscript negative 1 represents an electron that, although physically identical to any other electron, comes from a nucleus, the one in the center of that atomic structure. During a decay process, a neutron is converted to a proton and an electron. The electron of the beta particle is not from the atomic orbital, but from the nucleus. I will talk about the decay process later. Let us now go to the alpha, beta, and gamma particles. When Ernest Rutherford found that unstable nucleus could emit particles in radioactive decay processes, he also discovered that double-charged helium nuclei, He2 positive, or alpha particles, were emitted along with the beta particles. Referred to as the double-charged helium, the alpha particle, therefore, has 2 neutrons and 2 protons, so its atomic number is 2 and its atomic mass is 4. The beta particles, on the other hand, can either be high-energy electrons with a negative charge or particles with the same mass as an electron but with a positive charge. This latter particle is a positron, and we might as well expect it carries a notation of E positive. Because it is a matter that carries an opposite charge, it fits the name antimatter. When a positron is emitted, it rapidly loses energy until it meets an electron. This interaction annihilates, or to put it bluntly, wipes out the electron and positron to produce a pair of gamma rays which move in opposite directions. Take note, all elements with an atomic number that is greater than 83 are radioactive. Take note that writing a nuclear reaction equation is a bit different from writing equations for chemical reactions. You need to know the symbols of chemical elements, and you must indicate the protons, neutrons, and electrons, specifically the number of protons and neutrons of every species in the reaction equation. Thus, here are the rules to follow in balancing a nuclear equation. Rule number one is the conservation of atomic mass, A. The rule states that the sum of the proton plus neutrons in the products must equal the sum of the protons plus neutrons in the reactants. The second rule is the conservation of atomic number, Z, or nuclear charge. Thus, the sum of the nuclear charges in the product must equal to the sum of the nuclear charges in the reactants. Knowing the atomic numbers and atomic mass of all species in a nuclear equation, except of course that of the unknown species, we can identify the unknown species by applying these rules on balancing nuclear decay equations. Okay, for example, the nuclear reaction U-235 plus neutron 1 into cesium-138 plus rubidium-96 plus 2 neutron 1. To check if the reaction is balanced, rule number 1 is conservation of atomic mass. So we add the atomic masses of the reactants and equate it to the sum of the atomic masses of the product. Thus, 235 plus 1 equals 138 plus 96 plus quantity 2 times 1, or 236 equals 236. So that checks out. We have a balanced equation based on the atomic masses. Then, according to rule number 2, we add the atomic numbers of the reactants and equate to the sum of the atomic masses of the products. Thus, 92 plus 0 equals 55 plus 37 plus quantity 2 times 0, or 92 equals 92. So that checks out again. We have a balanced equation based on the atomic number. With both atomic masses and atomic numbers balanced, we can finally conclude that the reaction is balanced. Let's have a sample problem. The problem is, write the balanced nuclear equation for the decay of polonium-212. In case you're wondering why the problem only indicates polonium-212 or PO-212, take note that since an element has a specific number of protons, we generally do not include the atomic number Z in the symbol. What does it mean? For example, carbon has 4 isotopes, which would be represented as carbon-12, carbon-13, carbon-11, and carbon-14. These isotopes have different atomic masses, 12, 13, 11, and 14. However, all these isotopes have the same atomic number Z equal to 6. For convenience in this course, when writing, we will maintain both the mass number and the atomic number in the symbol. Going back to the problem, the nuclear reaction is polonium-212 into lead-208 plus the unknown particle. As shown in the reaction, the reactant polonium has an atomic mass of 212 and an atomic number of 84. On the other hand, the product lead has an atomic mass of 208 and an atomic number of 82. To solve for X, the mathematical equation is according to the first rule, the conservation of atomic mass, 212 equals 208 plus A of X. Simplifying, A of X is equal to 212 minus 208. The difference is 4, hence the atomic mass of X is 4. Then, according to the second rule, the conservation of atomic number of the nuclear charge, 84 equals 82 plus Z of X. Simplifying, Z of X is equal to 84 minus 82. The difference is 2. Hence, the atomic number or nuclear charge of X is 2. Since the atomic mass A of X is 4 and the atomic number of the nuclear charge of X is 2, the balanced nuclear reaction is therefore polonium PO212 into lead PB208 plus X with superscript 4 and subscript 2, or as a nuclear reaction, polonium PO212 into lead PB208 plus alpha particle with superscript 4 and subscript 2. How do you know it is an alpha particle? Well, recall that alpha particle has two protons and two neutrons. So its atomic number is 2 and its atomic mass is 4. Thus, from our calculation, we therefore have an alpha particle. Recall also that Ernest Rutherford discovered the double charged helium nuclei He2 positive, or helium with an atomic number of 2, otherwise known as the alpha particle. The next problem is write the balanced nuclear equation for the decay of cesium-137. The nuclear reaction is cesium-137 into barium-137 plus the unknown particle. As shown in the reaction, the reactant cesium has an atomic mass of 137 and an atomic number of 55. On the other hand, the product barium has an atomic mass of 137 and an atomic number of 56. To solve for X, the mathematical equation is, according to the first rule, the conservation of atomic mass, 137 equals 137 plus A of X. Simplifying, A of X is equal to 137 minus 137, and the difference is 0. Hence, the atomic mass of X is 0. Then, according to the second rule, the conservation of atomic number or the nuclear charge, 55 equals 56 plus Z of X. Simplifying, Z of X is equal to 56 minus 55. The difference is 1. Hence, the atomic number or the nuclear charge of X is 1. Based on our calculation, the atomic mass A of X is 0 and the atomic number Z on the nuclear charge of X is 1. Therefore, the balanced nuclear reaction is cesium-137 into barium-137 plus X with superscript 0 and subscript 1. And this will be written as cesium-137 into barium-137 plus beta particle with superscript 0 and subscript 1. Again, how do you know it's a beta particle? Well, did you notice that the atomic mass is the same for the reactant and the product, but the atomic number of the product is 1 more than that of the reactant? Recall that in a neutral atom, the atomic mass is equal to the total number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. If the atomic mass is 0, there is therefore no proton nor neutron in the reaction. Recall also that the number of protons, which is the atomic number, is numerically equal to the number of electrons. In this nuclear reaction, there is no proton and there is no neutron, yet we have an atomic number of 1. The reaction does not only result in the production of barium, but a neutron in the cesium nucleus is likewise converted into a proton and a high-energy electron during the radioactive decay. The high-energy electron is the negative beta particle. This is an electron that is ejected from the nucleus, however, the proton is retained in the nucleus. So that's it. That is how we arrive at the nuclear reaction cesium-137 into barium-137 plus beta particle with superscript 0 and a subscript negative 1. Finally, let me tell you this. You don't have to love chemistry, but the journey will be much easier if you open your heart. Think, radioactive. Radioactive, radioactive, welcome to the new age, welcome to the new age. Bye guys, enjoy the journey.